want to go for those crowd control setups onto Lily and try to take someone down very early on.
Yeah, the Windwalker Mage that we saw earlier is going to play similarly to this Rogue Mage. However, the Rogue Mage can do it much more frequently, and Mauro is running that Frigid Grasp Azerite trait, so his damage is going to be insanely higher than we saw from Hong's Mage, which could be devastating for the deleters. We see initial attacks towards Bic Mex, tons of damage, and just closing it out instantly, making a movie take game one.
That's the power of that trait. You know, Mauro was able to get so much damage out very early on, and they were just they executed
the hook point so far in competitive.
I think it might be.
We saw it in this region. Yeah,
this region.
Yeah, in this region. Okay.
All right.
Here we go. Let's see if they can get that big pressure we saw earlier. Mauro actually got flared out of stealth. This is the best map for finding anyone in stealth because it's such a narrow map. There's not really many paths you can go down, and it's very unlikely that you can dodge that initial flare. It's a great map for hunters against rogue and mages. It's a nice pick by the team of the deleters, but they got deleted in game one. Let's see if they can survive. Bic Mex is again playing relentless, but he is human. He human racials into another stun. Tons of damage. Gets Aspect of the Turtle off on 10% and hangs on. Smoke Bomb still available. Making a movie, still have a lot of damage available in another 40 seconds. They've actually kept the crowd control chain going. Lily trinkets into a psychic scream, fully channeled Ray of Frost. Bic Mex jumps over. Pain Suppression has to get traded out. The deleters are far on the back foot.
I don't know. Making a movie could be in some trouble here too. Ratapai traded out his trinket early on. Acro, no evasion, no vanish, no cloak of shadows. The deleters can hold on a little bit longer. Incarnation rolling. There's a fear on Ratapai. Once that pain suppression fades, making a movie, they have no defensives left.
All right, here comes the double stun combo. They drop the smoke bomb. They stun him with Ice Nova, but a barrier from Lily, well placed on that smoke bomb, absorbed a lot of that hits. It allows Bic Mex to easily survive. Ice Form coming up in 7 seconds. Mauro's going to look to secure a kill with that. They need to make sure they get a stun into Poly on Lily, Psychic Scream, or some other crowd control on Big Peter. If they can make it a 3-on-1, we can maybe should close this out. But in the meantime, Ratapai is crowd controlled. Acro's on the back foot. Mauro pops Ice Form to just counter pressure instead of peel, but he gets silenced. He actually trinkets a silence to keep the chain going. They're trying to get a kill with this Evan Bolt. Big hit. Bic Mex gets stunned again. They counterspell Big Peter on his off-heels. That triple crowd control from Making a Movie is gnarly. They're going to lead this series 2-0.
Yeah, I think Twitch chat might want to change up their vote as Making a Movie go up in game 2, 2-0, and now on match point in the series. And these guys...
The leaders actually found Mauro in stealth with a flare, so it was a much better start than they could really ask for. If they don't get that same start on this map, it could be devastating. Bic Mex sneaking in camouflage. There's a flare getting sent to midfield. Not going to hit anyone. Mauro's just inches away from it. That's a bit unfortunate for the hunter not finding him. Actually, Lily finds Mauro. That means they can't get a sap. Akro's moving in, likely for kidney shot. Polly. Mauro moving in, making a movie, just spreading up. Big Peter moves right in front of Akro and doesn't even see him. In stealth, they obviously are invisible, but if they get close, they can see each other for just a second. Ratify's charging in and spamming Holy Nova to try and pull somebody out of stealth, but he's not finding them. He thinks that Big Peter's hiding in the back of the room, but Peter's on the opposite end of the universe from where Ratapai is, and I guess they're really just trying to maybe find Acro with Flare. If they get lucky, that could be a great way to start the game, but so far, two Flares in a row, and they're not finding him.
Ooh, Ratapai might be able to pull out Bic here, and manages to do so. Looks like Acro's going to be charging in. There's the full blind. Once again, big setup coming in from Making a Movie. Can they take Bic down in the opener? Manages to get the Feigned Death off. That's going to be Thorns coming in from Big Peter as well. Full Polymorph, though, all alone. Aspect of the Turtle's going to be traded out, and that's not a good spot for the deleters.
I think Big Peter's playing Resto Affinity this game. He tossed out a big Swift Mend. But even with the Swift Mend, Bic Mex is in trouble on 10% with Pain Suppression. Hangs on by a thread. Ratapai and Acro went all in, though. They both used trinkets. Incarn is available. So is Coordinated Assault. The leaders have all their aggressive cooldowns. They can one-shot Acro if he's not careful. He needs to try and play away. He is playing Dwarf. He could trade that out, remove some of the bleeds, but the next trap on Ratapai could close the game. There's the stun. Incarn. Big Peter gonna pop it. He's being greedy. Acro pre-evasions, trying to avoid the stuns before they happen. Now looking to reverse pressure on Bic Mex, but not finding too much damage. Big Peter trying to fake cast the counterspell. Doesn't fake cast it. Could be an opening with Psychic Scream secured. Bic Mex on the run, but Ratapai going for Schism gets interrupted by Bic Mex as he's trying to kite. The crowd control is over. Bic Mex will survive. Acro still with no trinket. There's the Incarn, and the leaders are looking to swing back.
Yep, full fear on Ratapai. He uses the Pain Suppression preemptively, though. That's going to allow Acro to survive just a little bit longer. You can see the Ice Forms available. You can see Dark Archangels available. This is going to be very scary for the deleters. Looks like they want to just let it rip. Big damage, but Acro is in a lot of trouble, too. Has to kite away, and deleters strike back. taking down Acro in game number three.
And still a really quick game. They won that one in only about 2-3 minutes. They just needed to survive that second setup, and they were able to do it. Now the leaders come in with the victory on game three, but a reverse sweep still a long way away. Both these teams
looking to try and kill some dreams in this tournament. It's unlikely they can qualify to BlizzCon, but they're trying to make their mark here in the first tournaments of Battle for Azeroth moving into next year, and they could be big contenders if they can make a mark here and take making a movie down. They managed to swing back in game number three. They need to do it two more times. On Dalaran Sewers, you see that red circle with the light slowly marching down. That's Flare. If any stealth targets move into it, they'll be pulled out and revealed to their opponent. So BikMix is trying to avoid being found and flare somebody out of stealth against the Rogue Mage and take their surprise. Flare right on top of Morrow, but not going to find Acro. He would have much rather found Acro. Acro's moving over, trying to find BikMix, but not going to commit overextending just too far. If BikMix gets lucky with a flare, it could be huge for them in the initial part of this match.
Yeah, on the other end of the spectrum, though, Ratapai looking to get out BikMix out with a Holy Nova. You can see Morrow spamming with the Blizzard. It's just a matter of time before they get lucky, unless BikMix is just incredible at avoiding, and he's been doing a good job so far in this game, but they're really just playing it patient. I think if they can get the Hunter out of stealth, then making a movie, they can move in, get on the target that they want once again, but this is risky for Acro as well. He needs to play very far away from this Hunter.
Camouflage is over. They can see BikMix making a movie or moving in. They still don't want to get pulled out of stealth, so they got to be a bit cautious. There's a flare defensively. Acro needs to try and navigate around that and get stuns. Shadow steps in, lands the stun. Where's the damage? BikMix trinkets instantly in Feigned Death, disengaging, but he gets Shadow Step reconnect. Frozen Orb is down. Ice Form is popped. Potential tons of damage here still available. BikMix is trying to be greedy and only trade Exhilaration. This is a great start for them, having only traded Pain Suppression. They hold onto that Vital cooldown. They got Acro's Trinket and Ratapai's Trinket. They've set them up for a huge win condition moving forward.
Yeah, making a movie, trying to execute the same strategy. It's not working, though. Deleters, they figured it out. A lot of pressure now onto Acro. Like you said, he doesn't have his Trinket. Next time Ratapai goes into crowd control, it's going to be very scary, but there's the full blind on Lele. I think he actually did that. Excellently done. He's going to get out of the crowd control into a full polymorph, though. But BikMix, he's just not under any pressure whatsoever. Unfortunately, Morrow, he's not going to be able to AoE, which is where most of that Frost Mage damage comes from. So if he's stacked up on the Priest, Morrow really can't get out significant burst.
Big Peter popped his Incarn a little bit too early there, and Acro preemptively evasion, dodged the stun, and now is playing defensively. They've avoided the Incarn. That was a huge win condition, and the deleters got overeager. They saw the win in the bag and pulled the trigger just a little bit too fast. Now they're on the back foot with a stun on BikMix and a poly on Lele, but there's just no damage. BikMix is taking not nearly as much pressure as we saw in the first two matches of the game. Ice Form popped, but it's actually Acro on the back foot. They drop Smoke Bomb in desperation, but Acro is flailing to stay alive. Ratapai has burned all of his mana playing aggressively. If Ratapai's team don't win in the next stun, they're going to be going to game five.
Yeah, Pain Suppression is going to be thrown out as well. The last line of defense. Acro all alone looking for a stun lock on BikMix once again. There's a fear on Lily. Nicely done. Is there any follow-up? There is. Acro looking to get aggressive, but he's just forced into such a defensive position. Ratify throwing out the last little bit of his mana to heal up Acro as they look to take down BikMix, throwing out the aspect of the turtle. But now, deleters, they're going to be able to recover, and I don't think making a movie has that same luxury.
Nice moves from the deleters, cleaning this series up now and taking it to a game number five. There's a game-breaking adaptation gear change from BikMix in this matchup. He realized all he has to do is live that stun lock and he's going to survive, so he switched his trinkets to our favorite friends, the tank trinkets.
They're back.
All right, the deleters have forced making a movie to change compositions. Their classic Frost Mage subtlety, Disciplined Priest, has been thrown aside for this substitute Shadow Priest, Assassination, Holy Paladin. We see this composition a lot in North America with the Gosu crew, formerly The Move. With a Paladin, they lose a lot of defense, but they gain a lot of offense. I think the quickest line to victory for the deleters is actually tunneling the Holy Paladin. He only has the Divine Shield and the Blessing of Protections, which Lele can remove both of. And if they cross crowd control the Shadow Priest, they remove a lot of damage and utility. And I'm wondering what strategy the deleters are going to move for on this map.
Yeah, we'll definitely have to see. Big Peter, he's going to be moving in, it looks like. Valet trying to get him out of stealth, but not going to. Then nice setup over onto Valet. If they can stop his insanity generation, he is a good target very early on. But it looks like making a movie, they want to get aggressive with a kidney shot on Lele. Pain Suppression going to be activated immediately into the cheap shot. He should be able to survive with this for now, but making a movie, that's an interesting strategy choice.
Yeah, they managed to pull Pain Suppression and Rapture, so they banked a lot of defensive cooldowns from Lele. Now they're mind controlling him, ramping up their momentum onto a different target, which is likely to be Big Mix or Big Peter, but not really doing too much. It's actually Akro that's heavily on the back foot, trading out both Cloak of Shadows and Evasion. Ratapai caught into a freezing trap. They interrupt the Mass Dispel. Good crowd control. Akro is heavily overextended, still chasing down the healer, and this overextension could cost him the game. Gets stunned up. Ratapai moves in, saving him in the final seconds.
Yeah, Ratapai not being positioned really hurt Akro there. Like you said, he traded out the Cloak of Shadows, the Evasion, and the Stone Form. So basically every single defensive he has available. Now it's all up to Ratapai to keep him alive. And if Lightly can keep forcing Akro to overextend, this is a good position for deleters to be in.
The strategy that Mickey and the movie are playing, they should have ran Shaman instead of Paladin. It's way too exposed to crowd control with them playing the mid game. Akro's just overextending, and the strategy from Making a Movie is getting, it's just falling apart basically. Akro's always on the back foot. He's trying to go after the healer, but he has to overextend to do it. He's going to overextend in line of sight Ratapai. Ratapai's trying to move in and stay with his team. Silence on Lele out of the stun. Good cross crowd control on Big Peter. They've isolated the healer. He trades out that barrier, absorbing a lot of hits. They are putting Lele on a clock though. He is burning through a lot of mana quite rapidly. If Making a Movie can clean up their defense, they can win on that front.
Lily had a very sick play. Once again, he deathed another blind from Akro, so Making a Movie isn't going to have that crowd control available due to the nice outplay from Lily. Nice triple fear coming in for a second. Ratapai looks to be the target of choice. He's going to be attacked quite heavily, but he manages to escape with the freedom, with the Divine Steed, gets away, tops himself off, and now Making a Movie wants to get aggressive once again, but there's a full trap on Ratapai. Akro all alone behind the pillar. Valet throwing out the mind controls, trying to slow the deleters down just a little bit, but Lily's just making it so difficult for Making a Movie to commit. Ratapai struggling to get the heals on Akro in this situation. There's a full kidney shot on Lily into a silence. He could get taken down right now. He has the rapture up, but just can't get any of them off. Finally getting a huge heal from Big Peter, stabilizing him just a little bit, but his mana is so low.
Right now, both teams are on the ropes. There's not many defensive cooldowns for the side of Making a Movie. Full freezing trap, Valai. Life switches his health. Big Mix switches over. He's trying to gun down Valai, forcing the dispersion. No defensive cooldowns really now on Making a Movie as Akro trades evasion out before anything even hits him. Lily's got no mana, no cooldowns. It's a race to the finish, potentially a cross kill. Lily is the one that's falling behind at the moment. Kidney shot, is silence available? Doesn't appear to be. Lily can safely get out of that stun now. They need to get a kill on Akro in these next couple of seconds. They've ran out the clock. They've got no mana left. They need crowd control on Rata. Big Peter makes a move over, stunning him up. Akro preemptively shadow steps behind the pillar, but it's a race to the finish. He's got nothing. Ratapai sneaks in a sacrifice, and now Lily is completely tapped. He's silenced up. If Akro connects to Lily, he's surely going to go down. He's line of sighting for his life, doing whatever he can to keep his team going for another trap. How much longer can Lily keep this up, Ben?
He has the pain suppression. Big Peter getting swapped to now. Blind on Lily. Big Peter could be in a lot of trouble. He's trying to line of sight in bear form. Thorns activated as well, trying to reduce as much damage as possible. But they are in so much trouble. Pain suppression gets activated by Lily. That might be what it takes to keep him alive.
Trap.
Now a full trap on Ratapai. He has the trinket, being a little greedy, not trinketing out right now. Akro's all alone. He doesn't have anything left. Unfortunately, he might just go down in this situation.
Oh,
I'm
no.
not sure what? What happened.
Oh no, Ratapai, I think he needed to trinket that trap. If he had it available, then that would have been the game right there. Lily was completely out of mana, but deleters will take game five and knock Making a Movie down to the lower bracket. They will be in the top three on Sunday. And in a complete turn of events, Zico, they go from 2-0 down to completing the reverse sweep here.
Very nicely done reverse sweep there at the end. And what ended up happening was Ratapai didn't have his trinket for a couple of more seconds. Ratapai pre-sacrificed the trap that was before this one. Then the trap cooldown came off in the middle of things, and he got trapped on his Divine Steed. Big Mex managed to snipe one out. And then, of course, Akro, having used his evasion.
Feed versus the fake Zebras, we're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.